We are charging this individual with one count of terrorism causing death, four counts of first-degree murder, seven counts of assault with intent to murder, and 12 counts of possession of a firearm and the commission of a felony. When the shooting started yesterday, the students and teachers and staff in the school had to act quickly to save their own lives. Law enforcement and all of the first responders had to act quickly to prevent more lives from being lost and to get help for those who have been shot. Last night and this morning, we had to act quickly to review the evidence that has already been gathered and issue these initial charges. Going forward from today, the process becomes more methodical. As the sheriff said last night, there is a lot of evidence still to be collected. There are important facts still to be gathered. The process will take time. The investigators and my office will pour through all of those facts. They will make sure that we have left no stone unturned to get to the answers to all of your questions, our questions about how and why this happened. So today is only beginning, and it's possible there could be additional charges issued very soon when that investigation is reviewed and complete. We are in close contact with the investigators and the sheriff. Please understand that I cannot and they cannot disclose any details or evidence that could compromise our case. I will not do that to the victims of these, the families of these victims or and our community. And this needs to be our focus. We are ethically bound not to reveal those details. I want to explain why we are charging this suspect as an adult in this case. First, the seriousness of the crime this person committed under Michigan law. There are crimes that the legislature has said are so serious that a person who commits them can automatically be charged as an adult. First-degree murder is the most serious of all those crimes. Second, there are facts leading up in the shooting that suggest this was not just an impulsive act. Those facts are not appropriate for discussion right now because it could affect the prosecution of this case. Lastly, charging this person as an adult is necessary to achieve justice and protect the public. Any other option would put all of us at risk of this person because they could be released and still a threat. My job is to protect our community from people who commit these kinds of crimes. And that's what I'm going to do. Let me explain the next steps. A short time ago, these charges were issued, and law enforcement is swearing to these charges currently. The suspect will be arraigned later this afternoon. To prevent further tragedies like the one we witnessed yesterday, and at large, we have got to address responsible gun ownership in this country and in Oakland County. Responsible gun ownership, including the security of a gun, is an absolute imperative to protect our community today and in the future, and those who do not do that should be and will be held accountable. Kids deserve better, parents deserve better, teachers deserve better. We have to do better, and I'm committed to seeking justice for the victims of the Oxford High School shooting and all Oakland County kids who face violence. It's my fervent hope that this will be the last time we experience an incident like this happen in Oakland County or anywhere. I'm committed to doing my part to ensure we honor the lives of those lost, those taken, by pursuing this case with the full weight of this office. And now I'll take questions.
You say that this wasn't an impulsive act, if you don't want to talk about it. I mean, don't you owe some explanation to folks about what that is? And we've been asking about that, the community's been asking about that. There's got to be something you can give us in terms of what that impulsive act is. I understand you have a whole prosecution to do, but there's a way to do that. And I think given everything with this case, I think folks are owed some kind of an explanation as to what led up to this.
I have a professional ethical duty not to disclose facts that will jeopardize the prosecution of the case or threaten a fair trial, which would be the absolute worst thing for the victims of this shooting. Second, we've charged four counts of first-degree murder, which requires premeditation. And I am absolutely sure, after reviewing the evidence, that it isn't even a close call. It was absolutely premeditated.
And what about the father? Is he under investigation? Is he facing any potential charges to talk about responsible gun ownership?
We are considering charges against both parents, and we will be making decision swiftly.
Thank you.